okay? What's the matter?
What?
You've been quiet all morning. Obviously, something's wrong.
I'm just a bit tired.
Bullshit.
Can you just get back on the road, please?
No. Not until you tell me what's going on.
What are you doing?
Listen, I know you too well. I know when something's wrong. I know when you've got something on your mind. So you may as well tell me now.
Do you remember what I told you when we first got together?
What?
Do you remember what I said I needed more than anything else? I told you I needed your time.
Go on like I don't know these things.
Well, clearly you don't, because if you did, we wouldn't be here today.
What do you mean?
Like, right here, you wouldn't feel the need to do this. It's like you're trying to prove something. You're trying to show me how much you can do for me in 4 days. Like, take me to lunch, dinner, cinema, take me shopping. And then tomorrow morning, you'll be off boarding a plane and it'll be back to square one again. And you seem to think that's normal.
Yeah, because this is my new normal and I'm trying to get used to it. None of this is my fault, you know.
It's never your fault. The day you chose to leave wasn't your fault either, was it?
I had to do it.
No, you didn't. You could have just decided that what you had here with me was far more important and that whatever your dad was going through back home could have been dealt with by someone else back home.
And who would that be? My dad is sick, Florence. Don't you get that? He needs me, and that's why I have to keep going back. You think I enjoy all this? You think I really wanted to leave everything I had here to go and look after him? He has no one. No one.
I understand that. But you said it would only be for a short period of time.
He got worse over time. I had to stay.
I know. I'm just saying, me and you could have done so much more. Like, I wanted to experience so many things with you. I wanted us to travel, do things that normal couples do.
Yeah, we'll get to do all that eventually. But right now, I've got to be there for my dad. Don't know what this disease does to people. Don't know. Before Mum died, she made me promise one thing. She told me that my dad would need me. I already knew what to expect. I knew he would refuse to come to London. She told me all this. She told me to be strong. She told me that all the evil that he accumulated over the years would eventually kill him. That was before she forgave him. So I promised. I said I'd look after him until the end. It's just a shame that it gets in the way of us two.
Is it really fair though? Look at what she went through all those years because of him, and look how it ended. You don't have to be the one to pick up the pieces.
I don't have to. But I choose to. I forgave him for what he did to my mum because she forgave him. And this doesn't mean that I don't love you. It just means that I'm doing what's right. I do miss you when I'm out there.
You may love me and miss me, but I don't think you're doing enough to make sure you don't lose me.
Don't make this any more difficult for me. Can't you see I'm trying my best here?
Your best would really be your best if you just decided to let your dad deal with the consequences of his own mistake.
What, and let him die alone?
But why should you have to witness that anyway?
Because he's my dad, he's family, and you're not. Yet. I didn't mean it like that. Florence. Florence, wait.
biggest lie I tell myself is that I don't give a damn about you anymore. I wish I had the strength to leave. We've been together for 4 years, Isaac. And for the last 2 years, I've had to accept the fact that this has now become a long-distance relationship because you choose to spend most of your time in Sierra Leone taking care of a man who made your mum suffer to death, literally, and was absent during your entire childhood. Like, do you know how hard it is for me to come to terms with that?
What my dad did in the past doesn't matter to me anymore. He's my dad. I've chosen not to turn my back on him.
Just know that by doing that, you're turning your back on me.
Well, if it's that difficult for you to accept the fact that I have to divide my time between London and Sierra Leone, then you're free to walk out this car.